So to see what the programmer has to go through, let's look at the message passing program. This is a relatively simple program. What it's trying to do is compute a sum of a relatively large array in parallel on four cores. So this is the overall array size. It has 1024 elements. This is the number of processors we have. In a message passing program, each of the processors will get one quarter of the array. They cannot access each other's memory directly. So each one of them only allocates its part of the array in its memory. Each of them will have its own sum variable. And then what happens is each of them iterates over its part of the array, adding those array elements to the sum. This, of course, assumes that the elements of the large array have somehow been distributed to all of the processors. If they haven't been distributed already, then we need to also write code that will actually send the elements of the array so that each of them gets a quarter of the array. Once we have computed the sum, we need to compute the final sum. And to do that, we have to communicate. So what we will do is we will have one of the processors act as the summing up agent, and it will, for every other processor, receive the sum sent by that processor and add it to its sum and then print the final overall sum. What do the rest of the processors do? Well, what they do is they send to processor zero what they have collected so far, and that's all they do. So as you can see, we need to explicitly send and then receive things in order for communication between processors to happen. And also we have to explicitly control what gets into whose part of memory. We need to explicitly also in the program figure out how to match the sends and receives, because if we send something and it's not received, it's going to be a problem. And also if we wait to receive something and there is no send for it, it's going to be a problem. We get stuck here. So we need to know how many processes to wait for. We need to send exactly what's expected at the time and so on. But once we do all of this correctly, it's very easy for the programmer to see which parts of this program are going to be expensive as far as communication is concerned, because these are all local accesses, so they're relatively fast, and these are the only places where we actually communicate.